I come out to the hangar a lot. I've been through the museum when I was younger. I used to come out here and look at all the planes and watch them have their air shows they used to have out here. Really exciting stuff with their B-24 and B-25 and all that.
My name is Clint Epley. I'm a colonel in the Commemorative Air Force, retired commander in the U.S. Navy. The hangar was put in 1942. So it's the last building that's created for the original San Marcos Army Airfield. And it's now considered a city historic landmark. I've worked here for 20 years. How's that? And I've enjoyed every minute. I had a paying job part-time after I retired from the Navy. Found that I liked being over here volunteering a lot more than I liked the paying job. So I'm here now. We have about 150 members, and there's not one paid member on that list.
My name's Joe Ensminger. I'm the wing leader of the Central Texas Wing, so I'm the volunteer leader of the group. I think the thing I've learned most from the older generation out here is just how humble they are about what they've accomplished. I mean, this group of men and women have done things that I think we can't even imagine doing. So, like the C-47 we have in the hangar, you know, 74 years ago, there were some young men that were 18 years old that got on that airplane in the dead of night, flew over the English Channel and jumped out of it, knowing that there was a pretty significant chance that they were gonna get killed in the effort. And they don't talk about it. They, you know, you have to pull that story out of them. So they're heroic, but they're also very humble. And so I think that's a trait that I think, you know, we could use these days, or people that can sort of be heroes but don't have to talk about it all the time.
They have been nothing but welcoming and inviting. Really excited to have extra people in here. We can always use the help. They started teaching me from day one and showed me what I needed to learn. So it's been a wonderful environment.
We can't exist if we don't have people to take over after we get too old to do it. It's kind of a struggle to get the younger people in here, but we still try.
Go push on it.
Robbie is probably my most energetic young volunteer here, and I think you've talked to him. He's absolutely thrilled to be able to talk about the museum. He likes history. Everything he's doing in school right now.
Actually, okay, so it's a drop tank turn bomb. I volunteer in the museum. I give people tours, take them up in the aircraft whenever I can or whenever it's safe to. I show them just basically every corner of the hangar, if they want to at least.
He just can't wait. When he comes here, he usually comes in through the door running because he's so excited about working here. We need people like him. I mean, that's the kind of people we absolutely love.
I do like spending my time up here, helping other people get educated, because commonly on the weekends, there you can see a high number of kids come by with their parents, and so it's cool that the parents are helping their kids get educated.
He likes to be the guy that talks to people when they come in, and the people absolutely adore him. He's just fantastic. More people like him I could use every day.
Putting the kids in the planes can be really fun, but touching all the controls and stuff when they're not supposed to is one of the downsides. But some of the most fun is seeing their smiles at the end of the day and thinking about how I changed some people's lives, so it's pretty fun.
We have a lot of really cool stuff.
He is absolutely interested in history and the items of this, and being able to discuss World War II history. And that's primarily what we do.
I am definitely hoping to come back here in the future, no matter how old I am or what I'm doing or where I am.
What we do through the cadet program at the Civil Air Patrol, we teach the younger generation from 12 to 18, with the few exceptions to 21, and we teach them about aerospace and leadership and give them classes. And the seniors, the adult leadership that are here, they help mentor us as cadets to pass down that information and history of aviation and aerospace.
I think the most important thing that we can pass on the most important thing we can pass on is an appreciation for history, and also an inspiration to make their own history. So this generation is writing their own story, and they're going to be called upon to do some things that are going to require courage and require some, maybe even some sacrifice, and being able to give them sort of a historical context for what's possible, they can step up and do that, I think is important. and inspire them. So we love, you know, all this is about a passion for aviation. So at the end of the day, we want young people to be excited about aviation, excited about flying, excited about serving their country. And that's what we're about.
Whatever happens at the hangar stays at the hangar.